boring when a team's thriving, right? But my understanding was after practice earlier today, the coaching staff pulled the youngster aside and I think challenged him to see where can you be better. Yes, things going well right now, but is there room for improvement? I think the coaching staff sees that an opportunity to get a little bit more out of their youngster and see if they can try to move this win streak to maybe 6 games, because this team's humming right now. But I think if the youngster can maybe turn it up a little notch, they might be able to keep the good times going for an extended period. Meantime, when you look at some of the other issues going on around the league, game show continues. We'll get to the phones in just a moment, but how about the rookie's performance out there on this night? Wow. Was challenged to be, you know, can you give us more? And the coaching staff saw an opportunity to say, hey, I think there's more you can give. You know what? The youngster delivering certainly showed that there was more to give as they extend that winning streak and keeps the good times going. And the home crowd loving that, as I can see on social media here and taking all sorts of calls we'll get to in just a quick moment. Let's go to the phones here now. Who's on line one? You know what? And that's a great point. And thank you very much for the call there, Jackson. And, you know, when you look at some of the players out there and the young players in the league that are making people take notice, I think you have to look at him and what he has done so far in his early steps in the National Hockey League. You know, up front, he's finding a way to the net. He's finding a way to engage. You know, he's also showing a two-way game. And for young players, you don't see that often. That usually takes a lot longer. And I've been really impressed from what I've seen from this young man in his early steps in his career in the National Hockey League. All right, back to the phones we go. We've got Dylan on line five. Hey, Dylan. Obviously, a lot of people curious with the rookie watch going on as to who will be the NHL's top rookie this year. And two of these go head-to-head tonight. Now, my little birds, my little spies within the room told me that prior to this one, the coaching staff has actually challenged their young dynamite rookie to see if he can outperform the other front runner in this Calder race. I like the challenge. So don't sing it, bring it on. I'm looking forward to see how this all plays out coming up later on tonight. This is going to be fun. You know, and I want to say this. I want to go back to the whole notion and the conversation about the sophomore slump. Because from what I've seen so far in his second year, that does not exist. Does not exist so far from this young forward, right? I mean, he shows up and he competes and the consistency in his game. Look, it's a long season. I get it. And a lot can happen between now and the finish line. But to me right now, the idea of a sophomore slump, yeah, preposterous. How does that sound? All right. Is that convincing enough for you? Preposterous. I just love that word. But anyway, no sophomore slump here. Okay. Let's move on. Back to the phones we go. Levi, how are you? Time to take a look at what happened around the league as we check in on some of the scores. The Leafs look to run roughshod over the Red Wings. Toronto picks up the 2 points in the overtime win. The Knights took to the road to match up with the Blue Jackets. Vegas terrorized the goalie with a monster offensive display. The Lightning paired up with the Sabres. Tampa Bay pummels the opposition with a strong offensive output. We'll check the inbox, we'll check the text line, and hear what you have to say next. All right, welcome back to the show, everybody. James Cebulski with you. As promised, we'll get into Rookie Watch. You like how I put that effect on my voice there? Hey, look, showdown last night between two of the top freshmen in the game, and I know a lot of the hometown fans don't want to necessarily hear this listening to the show, but you know what? I can't say the hometown kid won this one. I mean, you look at the numbers, way better offensively in that performance last night than the other. And look, it's not a slight. I like the kid, all right? This is where I backpedal and say I really like him, but... conversation. Okay, U.S. Thanksgiving just around the corner, my friend. Turkey, gravy, or stuffing? Where do your power rankings go on that?
In that turkey gravy stuffing third.
Stuffing
although,
third.
Although, I do like stuffing in the sandwich the next day.
Yes. Now, there you go. This is what we can agree on. Okay, from a Calder standpoint, can we agree on the fact that the hometown kid probably isn't in the discussion right now?
He's not. I mean, his immediate concern has to be staying in the lineup. He's really struggled at times. He looks young, really looks like a rookie. The guys that are going to compete for the Calder, they seem to be, you know, playing above their age, and he's not done that yet.
Can we get a sense of where things look at elsewhere around the league? World, and I want to bring it back closer to home for a lot of you listening right now. The rookie getting a chance to play or participate with the power play unit earlier today at practice. Now, look, we all know the struggles. We've talked about it on this show in the past. And you know what? I like the opportunity, a little youthful enthusiasm. What have you got to lose? Because status quo, not good enough right now. You're not getting results. I like the change up here. Now, meantime, elsewhere around the hockey world. Let's check in on some of the final scores across the league tonight. The Preds were hoping to take a bite out of the Lightning. Tampa topples their opponents with a strong effort late. The Senators were hoping to play spoiler against the Stars. Dallas pulverizes the opposition with a big offensive night. The Kings were on the road to take on the Maple Leafs. Los Angeles tosses home the overtime winner and celebrate the two-point victory. Time for a quick break, but we got a lot more coming up on the ice next. I want to bring it back to the storyline that we were kind of tracking going into this one, and you look at the man advantage, and suddenly it showed some signs of life with the addition with the coaching staff making that move, putting the freshmen up into that mix. They were able to capitalize, they were able to light the lamp, and it sounds like, from what I've been told, that the youngster is not leaving that unit anytime soon. He is there to stay for the foreseeable future after finally getting some much-needed results. Elsewhere, you look at some of the box score and some of the numbers. Let's take a look at the rest of the action on the ice tonight in the National Hockey League. The Bruins were in a dogfight on the road up against the Golden Knights. Boston pulls one out in a nail-biter. The Capitals were looking to steal two against the Jets. Washington talked a big game going in. They back it up with a clean sheet shutout win. The Avs were hoping to come up with 2 points on the road against the Blues. Colorado pile-drive their opponents with a huge offensive night. Lots more puck talk coming your way, and we'll get to it next. Curious to see how the youngster goes into his sort of baptism of fire with this rivalry. I mean, you think of the history between these two teams, no love lost between either side. The fans always get amped up for this one. This is going to be a different adjustment for the intensity as to what this youngster is going to be used to from some of the other games that he has played to this point. I'm looking forward to it. I'm really curious to see how he responds to the challenge here. Now, some of the other key matchups as we look ahead. Now, if you're looking for a consolation prize despite the loss, look at the way the youngster played. Oh, boy. I really thought he was one of the best players out there. And when you go into a hostile environment like that for the first time as a young player in a rivalry game, you're not sure what you're going to get. You got one of his best performances, I thought, of the season from what we've seen in his young career. I really liked his game, played really well, was a difference maker for his team. Let's see where that goes from here, but that's got to be a nice boost to confidence. One area I didn't like in this one... Let's take a look around the league and some of the final scores out there tonight. The Ducks were on the road up against the Kings. Los Angeles tosses up a shutout performance thanks to a spectacular effort defensively on the night. The Blue Shirts were hoping to quiet the crowd on the road against the Penguins. Pittsburgh played their best in overtime, and they get the 2 points.